Hello YouTubers, this is Scott from Scott's Workshop. It's been a while since I've made any videos, and if you are a subscriber to my channel, you know that I've got a long string of videos, about 50 videos, that went over when I built my Teardrop camper, and you can see the Teardrop here in the background. I built my camper in 2013, and since that time have been building a lot of other things, built a couple of boats, and I built another camper. So this one has got to go. So that's what this video is about, that I'm putting my Teardrop for sale. I'm going to give you the price right now, and so if that sounds interesting to you, stay tuned. I'm going to go to some other details about the Teardrop, but I'm asking $8,000 for it. I am located in southeastern Virginia, and if you're interested in contacting me about buying the Teardrop, you can private message me through YouTube, and I'll respond to you there. So anyway, if you're still with me, I want to go over some of the details about the Teardrop, about how it's fared over the past couple of years, some things that if I was going to keep it, I might do, and just kind of show you its overall condition at this particular point. All right, so if you subscribe to and watched any of the videos that I made, you get an idea of the construction methods that I used and the materials that I used. So I'm not going to go into those things in big detail here, except to say that it's solidly built. I believe it's built to a professional standard, and most of the people who see it agree. And you know, I think it's held up pretty well. There are a couple of little things that I will point out to you, but like I said, I have moved on to another camper, and so you know, I want to sell this one and let somebody else enjoy it. So anyway, we'll just kind of walk around the Teardrop here, and you can see she's in good shape. So one of the things that I would probably do if I kept it is I would put another coat of shark hide aluminum protectant on it. She's starting to get a few little places where it's had some, you know, tree sap or something like that fallen on it, and then I've, you know, used some denatured alcohol to get it off of there, and I've taken off some of the shark hide. Well, the shark hide is good stuff. It's really, really easy to apply, and all you have to do is just wash it and then just wipe it on, basically. So so that's overall what she looks like. I'm gonna point out a couple of things. So you can see down here along the bottom, I think I went over this in one of my videos, we've got these these are drips, actually epoxy drips, and I went over how this happened. I was epoxy sealing the floor here, and it dripped down here, and I thought to myself, I really need to get a rag and wipe that up, and forgot. Came back the next day, it all set up. So what happens is that epoxy over time breaks down with the UV and just starts to flake off. So my plan, if I kept the Teardrop, would be to just kind of let that continue to oxidize, either that or just scrape it off, mask this, and then just paint it again. So that's no big deal. It's a cosmetic issue. The trailer frame itself could probably use some wax. We do have a couple of areas here where we're starting to get a little bit of surface rust, and this is just this is not structural. So this is basically some maybe a little bit of sandpaper or a scraper to scrape it, and then hit it with some Rust-Oleum, and that would fix it. So anyway, yeah, we do have a spare tire here. It's in good condition. It's never been on the road. And the tires are in good shape. The bearings are in good shape. And she rolls down the road nicely and tows very, very nicely. Okay, so go ahead and open the door. The doors still seal very well, have had zero water intrusion into the cabin, so cabin's in good shape. course the lights work and all of that. Now, there are a set of LEDs underneath this lip right here, which are operated, and they're tricolor LEDs. They're operated by a remote control. We did have a set of batteries leak in the remote control, and it's made it a little bit not as reliable as I would like it to be. That's pretty easily remedied by getting a different remote control or perhaps changing out the control box. Control box is inside the cabinet. It's right there. Hopefully you can see that. But you can see how the cabinets are built. Of course, the fan works. Works very well. This cabin is very well insulated. I've got, I believe it's 1.5 inches. I'd have to look at my videos again. But of insulation in the roof. I've got 3/4 of an inch of insulation, or actually one, maybe 1 inch of 3/4 of an inch of insulation in the walls and also in the floor. Even on cold fall nights in Maryland, when we were camping, we never had to put auxiliary heat in here. Just having two people in here heats it up nicely, makes it very comfortable. So we've got these auxiliary lights, and they work as well. So, and then these switches here are for my porch lights, which are also in good working order. Okay, here's a view of the cabin from the other side. Now, the mattress that we've got in here is a inflatable mattress. This is just from Walmart, I think. An inflatable mattress, and then it has egg crate foam over the top of it. Now, the mattress itself has a pinhole leak in it that we've not been able to identify. So we were not ever able to find it. It's a slow leak, but you did have to blow it up every night. So probably if you buy the Teardrop, then you need to go to Walmart and buy another inflatable mattress, which is not a big deal. So underneath the inflatable mattress, I do have exercise foam. This adds some insulation, some sound deadening, and makes a nice surface if you got to kneel in here and play with the mattress, or if you want to roll it up or something like that. So, okay, on the exterior here, you can see the trim work is still in good condition. One of the things that happens on pretty much any camper that uses these kind of this insert trim is that this vinyl part of the trim, as it ages, actually gets shorter. And so these have done that. And you can see there's some gaps here. Well, this stuff pops out and you can just pop in new trim. So, and this is readily available. So if I was going to keep it, I would probably just take it out and just put in some new trim in there. But it's not cracked or broken or anything like that. So you could just leave it as it is. Okay, so here's the hatch. I'll go ahead and open it. My props here. Now, one of the things that I did not do on this trailer is I did not put any kind of hydraulic or pneumatic assists to open the hatch. So, depending on your size and strength and desires, you may want to put hydraulic assists or pneumatic assists in the trailer when you buy it. I never saw the need to, so I'm, you know, use these regular supports here, and it seems to work for me. If you are interested in doing that, I have started to gather some information for doing the engineering on the supports, and I'd be happy to share where I found that information with you. I'd have to search for a little bit, but I should be able to find it. So if you decided you wanted to do that, otherwise you can just use these supports and they work fine. Okay, the slide outs. If you watch my other videos, you've seen how these work. And as I explained in one of my other videos, we decided not to do built-in cabinets. The reason being is we just didn't know what we wanted. So you could go ahead and build in cabinets, or you can do what we did. And we just bought some cabinets from, and the ones that we bought were plastic, but you could get them out, make them out of bamboo, or they could be some of the fabric mesh type that you can get from some of the like Bed Bath and Beyond and whatnot. Anyway, put cabinets here, and they were on this slide out. And then this slide out slides out like this and allows the cabinets to sit out here where you can get to them when the hatch is open. So these slide outs work. They're in good condition. You can see back here in the back, there's also a strip along the back edge of the teardrop, and I can turn on here, and you probably can't see it in the daytime here, but there's a set of lights back here that shine up here, and it makes for a real nice ambiance at night. There's also that tricolor LED strip back there, which is controlled by the same remote control as the inside. Okay, as well, here's for the box that I made for the water jug. So a water jug fits in here. I'll include the water jug with the sale of the camper. It just fits inside of this box, and then we put a dish pan here. That way you're not dealing with any kind of plumbing or anything like that. Works fine. So so that's the way our plumbing works, and no problems, and everything works fine. Now, go ahead and open up these cabinets. I'll show you what we've got inside here. Okay, so here's the cabinets opened up. You can see right here I've got my power center. So this is a WFCO converter and battery charger, and also provides 12 volt and 120 volt power to the teardrop. It's got a 20 amp breaker, and it's got a set of DC fuses as well. Camper is wired for AC and DC GFI outlets here, operating the AC side. Here's a battery cutoff switch. These are switches for this switch right here is for the lights back behind the cabinets, and this switch turns on a set of lights right here on the roof of the teardrop, on the roof of the hatch. All right. You can see I've got the battery out. And the reason is the battery's dead. So I will be replacing the battery with a sealed lead acid battery, otherwise known as an AGM battery. It'll be approximately 100 amp hours. Sits under here, is charged by the teardrop. And so if you decide to buy this teardrop, it will have a brand new battery in it. You can see inside of the inside of the cabinets here. Now, so here's a shot of the galley fully configured. Now, I don't have the flats for the cabinets pulled out, but you can see I do have the table set up, and this is usually where we would put our camp stove. So it's just a little accessory table that attaches to the back, and of course this goes with the camper as well. Okay, now I want to direct your attention to the only problem that I've had with the camper. So I think I went over in my last video how if I was going to redo this camper and redesign it before and build it again, I would make some slight changes to the way this seal works. But namely, I would just extend the lip out here so you didn't get any water in here. Well, this side is sealed up well with caulk and there's no water intrusion, but this side we did have some water intrusion. So had some water intrusion, and over the course of a winter I developed some rot in this side panel. So what I've done is I have cut out the rotten section, and actually more than the rotten section, just to make sure that I got everything. Cut a new piece of plywood, and this is the same plywood that the original is made from. So, and that's slightly different color now, but it should tone down in color to this existing sidewall. So I made sure when I did this one, I think I know what happened, is basically I had epoxied this surface. But I had not apparently epoxied underneath this lip. So what happened was the water would come down here and it would roll underneath this piece of plywood and got into the end grain and then rotted up into the end grain. It was rot about like that. So I cut it all out, cleaned it all up. This has epoxy underneath it. It also has epoxy that comes down to the aluminum and runs around the corner here. Now, this is ash, and that's why it turns black. Because ash turns black when it gets wet. But there is no rot anywhere else left in there, so it's been all cut out and been all repaired with epoxy. And then this has been sealed with polycrylic. So that's been all fixed. I also checked underneath here and got up underneath here to make sure there was no structural damage, and there was no structural damage. So so that's the main issue that I've had, and that issue has been repaired and fixed. So everything else is in good condition. So if I were searching for a teardrop, I would have no qualms about buying this one. So if you're interested, it's $8,000. I'm in southeastern Virginia. Send me a message on YouTube and I will respond to it, and let's make a deal.